This has been a year for movies about youth gangs, from The Warriors to The Wanderers, but no movie this year has been so perceptive about teenage crime as a low-budget drama called Over the Edge. It's set in a small community west of Denver. It's about kids who have no place to go and nothing to do in a suburban wasteland. It does a very good job of catching the way these kids really do think and really do behave. And here's a scene where the hero comes home to face his parents after being beaten up by a couple of young local hoods.
Carl! Come over here, I want to talk to you. Sit down.
What is it?
I had a talk with Sergeant Doberman this evening. I had to sit there while he warned me about keeping you in line or I'd find myself in some juvenile court somewhere.
What? Doberman said what?
I'm not finished. I saw you at that wreck yesterday when that boy was arrested, too.
Oh, I know you did. I'll bet you and Jerry Cole let Doberman bust the wreck on purpose, huh?
Is that what you think? Do you also think that I put that ounce of hash in Claude Zachary's pocket, do you? You think that, too?
Wasn't an ounce, Dad.
How in the hell do you know so much about it?
Did I get busted?
Oh,
Fred, let's just discuss this quietly. It's not necessarily Carl's fault that Claude...
It's never his fault, honey. It's always his friend's fault, right? His friends with the knives, his friends with the drugs. But I got a secret for you, Carl. Those friends of yours are going right to reform school, and you're not going to follow.
Who's going to reform school?
Carl, we don't want you to see your friend Richie White for a while. Or Claude Zachary either. Now, the teen centers are going to be closed for a while. At least until they can find a new counselor.
What's wrong with Julia?
I know you like her, hon, but it's obvious she can't control the wilder kid.
You're crazy.
Don't leave
while we're talking.
I said, don't leave. I'm not talking to you.
Stop that.
That was Michael Kramer in a very good performance as the son. And the movie's best scenes are between Kramer and Pamela Ludwig, who plays his girlfriend. When Over the Edge concentrates on these kids and their frustrations, on their angers, their yearnings, it's a very good and sensitive movie. But unfortunately, it goes for a big explosive climax in which the kids practically declare war on their parents. And that's not original, and it's not convincing. Over the Edge has such good stuff in it that I really wish it had avoided the Hollywood ending and stuck to its convictions.
Yeah, the parents are a bunch of boobs again in this picture. Good kids, rotten parents. That's easy trash to play up to kids in the audience. The film also has a basic flaw. The film argues that if these kids had more recreational facilities, they wouldn't riot at the end of the picture. Well, you could build 100 recreational facilities there, and the kids are still going to riot, because that's in the nature of this kind of picture, don't you think?
Yeah, I think so. For example, if you look at the ads, you hear the ads on radio and television, the ads make you think the whole thing is a war picture between teenagers and parents, and that's exploitation. It doesn't do justice to the good things in the movie.
Sure, and we get that every summer. Films playing up to young people who go to the movies most of all during the summer. This film does not work at all, I think. And how about this? Another disagreement. Roger liked Over the Edge, the teenage rebellion story. He liked it sort of. Again, I like the kids, but the adults were cartoon goofballs. I say no to Over the Edge. And maybe also what we're saying is when you try and put kids and parents together, it's too easy. You make a sloppy film if you make it all good kids and all bad parents.
So let's have more bad kids?
That's a good idea.
Okay. That's it for this show.